Hey guys, Mel the Train Tutor here with a sort of discussion topic. Now, I posted a video earlier with about techniques of cutting polystyrene with a saw, etc., and clamps and that sort of stuff. And it's caused a bit of a stir about, whether it's safe and whether I should have done a warning or whether I should be showing it children. And rather than reply in the comments, I actually thought, well, actually, it's a good topic to discuss. So this is all about, making terrain and the inherent dangers of making terrain. Yeah, be warned. So, what do I mean by that? Well, quite simply, yeah, everything in life comes with inherent dangers. Yeah, getting out of bed in the morning, yeah, you can trip over a toy, sprain your ankle, you can fall down the stairs, you can scald yourself making a brew, you can choke on your cereal, you can step out your door, trip over your store, crack your head, and you're dead. You can step out in front of a bus. Everything in life has inherent dangers, and what we do is we mitigate them, How likely is it that I'm going to get injured this way? I mean, if everyone thought, oh my God, if I step outside my door and I might bang my head, then no one would step out the door. But life goes on. Now, we've got sort of a nanny state going on, and it's been a trend since I was a kid where you see more and more warnings about things that are dangerous and more things that, don't do this, be careful, don't eat this, all that sort of stuff. And I'll be honest with you, my personal view is it's a bit OTT. But putting my personal view aside, let's just talk about terrain for a second. Now, the actual video that sparked this, I'll discuss at the end, but I just want to talk about making terrain. Now, first and foremost, I don't make these videos for young children. Okay, the fact of the matter is, one of these, a shark, okay, it's illegal for a 60 for an under 16-year-old to even own one of these in the UK. And generally, if you're under 16, then any projects involving saws, glues, that sort of stuff, you should be doing with a parent or an adult. Yeah, plain and simple, guys, when it comes to terrain, okay, terrain comes with inherent dangers like everything else. The fact of the matter is, we are using saws, we are using sharps, we are using electricity, we are using chemicals which give off noxious vapors. We are sanding MDF, which leads to fibers which can cause cancer if they get into your lungs. We're using airbrushes, ammonia cleaners, we are using all sorts of stuff. We're using tools, okay? And the fact of the matter, if something is designed to cut, then it will cut, and that means it will cut flesh again. Now, I sort of work on the principle that, generally, if I'm doing something with sharks, I'll give a token nod to watch your fingers. But if you're not smart enough to know, yeah, that sharp things can cut you, stay the hell away from them. Simple. Okay? And I don't mean to be patronizing about that, but they're sharps. These things can hurt you, so obviously you've got to go careful. You don't go blundering it. But the majority of accidents, okay, sorry, I'm getting off topic there. But what I do is, when I do these videos, if there's something which, isn't an obvious issue, yeah, but I'm aware that it's an issue, such as melting polystyrene, yeah, unless you actually know that they give off, harmful fumes, you wouldn't know. Yeah, whereas cutting something with a saw or a sharp is pretty obvious that it's dangerous. Yeah, so generally on this channel, what you'll find is I'll give specific warnings when there's a danger that you're unlikely to know about. Yeah, if it's something as obvious as using a sharp, then I don't think I need to explain that this is sharp. It cuts it sharp, that's its point. Yeah, same with saws and diamond saws and pin drills. I mean, I've got a mate who's a pro painter. He was doing a little bit of work. He was using a pin vise drill. He went straight through his model, straight through his nail, and hit an artery in his thumb and got an arterial bleed. Yeah, I mean, that can really take you down. A proper arterial bleed is a serious issue. You only did that with a little hobby drill. Okay, so it all comes down to, be aware that, a lot of the stuff that we do when we're building terrain isn't for little kids. I mean, I supervise my kids when they do it, and I'm very careful over what they do. And occasionally, they do have accidents. My little daughter, she got a little bit of hot glue on her finger, and it gave her a little bit of a burn. These things happen. It's part of growing up. Okay. But what I want to do now quickly is just to cover this off, look, we use tools, we use chemicals, when we make terrain. There comes with inherent risk like everything else. If it's not an obvious risk, I will tell you. If it's an obvious risk, I'm going to assume you've got the common sense to realize it's an obvious risk. And if you haven't got the common sense, go live in a padded room because that's where you belong. Okay? Save the NHS fixing you up because of your stupidity. Yeah, to the younger ones out there, don't attempt any of this sort of stuff. None of my tutorials, without a parent around or an adult. Yeah, even if it doesn't involve cutting stuff. Yeah, this is something you want to do around people if you're young. So that's my general principles on, the inherent dangers of making terrain. They're tools, they comes with risks, If it's an unobvious risk, I'll tell you. If it's an obvious risk, I'll assume you've got the common sense to know. Okay, otherwise, other than that, I will throw a warning up on every single one of my videos where I use one of these saying, warning, it cuts. Yeah, and trust me, you'll get right racked off with it pretty quick. So anyway, down to the actual tutorial in mention. Now I did a quick tutorial, I'll throw a link up to it, and because the caused a little bit of a stir. And the basic idea was I was showing you how to cut levels. Cut what you call it, pieces of polystyrene into slices. And the idea was that I got a couple of blocks, I lay a standard house saw on top of them, and I clamped them down. Now, I'd actually suggested that if you haven't got clamps, get someone else there to hold it. Yeah, and the idea was that you basically rub the polystyrene up and down. Yeah, and I get it. Yeah, looking at it and looking out from that camera view with all those sharp blades and my hand going up and down. Oh, it was so dangerous. Yeah, I can understand it may appear dangerous, but the fact of the matter is, it's probably the safest way to actually cut polystyrene when you think about it. Now, I've been a medic in the army for long enough to see plenty of injuries and plenty of accidents, and I can tell you that the majority of accidents involving sharps, such as saws, drills, and tools, okay, knives, all that sort of stuff, involve three things. One, excessive force in an accident. Okay, someone's trying to get through something, it jumps, it goes through, takes the thumb off. Yeah, that happens. Okay. Working in a weird position. You've got someone upside down like that trying to get to a bar and they can't properly get it and their hand's not properly moving. Yeah, that causes accidents. And plain stupidity. Yeah. And this is where someone will do something stupid like obviously lay their fingers in the track of the saw. And they're the three main reasons why you get traumatic accidents using sharps. Now, when I go back to my specific example, if you noticed, I got the block and I'm slicing it gently up and down. Okay? There is no massive force. That saw is not moving. Remember, to cut off a thumb or to do major damage with a saw, bore, you've got to sort of like have power behind it. And what you'll often find is that damage is done in one single stroke before you can counter it. Okay, normally because you're pushing through on something, bang, thumb's gone. Okay, with the technique I was showing guys, you're gently going up and down. There's no force on those, what you call it, on those teeth slicing. Yeah, there's a good couple of inches of polystyrene that my hand is gently cutting through. And you'll notice I did it gently. Okay, and I said, do it gently. Yeah, the other thing is, the only way to injure yourself in that situation is to get your hand and rub it up and down the blades. Now, if you're stupid enough to fight through the pain spasm response that your body is your natural defenses, then you deserve to get cut because that's the only way you're going to get cut in that situation. So I'm aware that a few people have sort of, oh, I don't think that's safe. Well, actually, guys, it's a lot safer than a lot of other techniques to cut it. Yeah, and it's actually a lot safer than using one of these. More injuries are caused by using these than a saw in hobbying. Okay? But what I'm trying to get down to you overall is, traumatic injuries happen when there's traumatic force. And there was no traumatic force in that. The only way you could severely injure, I mean, you might spike yourself on some teeth, ow. Yeah, but you're not going to lose a thumb unless you literally drag it up and down the blades. Okay? So don't worry about it. Okay? Right, so to recap, right, to all the young kids out there's nothing on this channel that you should do on your own. Always do it with a parent. To all the parents out there who've got young kids who want to attempt this sort of stuff, always supervise them. About the inherent dangers, be aware that obviously, if I'm using sharps, they're sharps. They're going to hurt if you're not careful. Okay, plain and simple, exactly the same reasons as with the saw and, excessive force in an accident, working in an unangled situation, a wrong position, and finally, being stupid. Yeah, those are the things that get you injured, not which way you have your saw. Okay, guys, and finally on that video, appreciate your feedback, guys. Yeah, and I can understand where you're coming from, but that's my explanation, and that's where it is. Now, I'm going to link to this from that video, so I cover it. Yeah, I am not going to put on warning saying, warning, I'm using a saw, it's sharp. Yeah, I credit you with more common sense than that, guys. Right, I've got more wonderful terrain to make, and just one other thing. Yeah, here's one for you, a little thought. If I was to make my terrain videos child safe, then that would mean I would have to mirror the school policy, which means I would be making terrain with sticky glue and plastic scissors. And if anyone can make good terrain with sticky glue and plastic scissors, I want to see it. I really do. But anyway, guys, that's just my little rant and my sort of my position on it all. I appreciate everyone else has got a different opinion, and you're welcome to it, and I will respect that opinion, but this is my opinion. So there you have it. Anyway, guys, enough about this. I've covered it now. I want to move on and make some terrain. So see you in the next terrain video, guys. All the best. Ta-ra.